Today, guys, we're actually creating this video to kind of give you a little bit of background on Hernan, kind of give you a little bit of history on where he's coming from. So we'll kind of start it off with that, Hernan. You know, if you can kind of tell the people, inform them on, you know, what kind of background are you coming from in the world of photography? You know, what kind of brought you to where you're at now?
Now, when you say history, how far back should I go? Because I could go pretty back.
Right.
I started as an illustrator. I started as an artist. My dad was an illustrator. I grew up painting. I grew up in art school.
Mm-hmm.
I grew up working in, you know, everything that related to art. And my whole career, actually, my dad was a photographer. So he was like, hey, listen, get involved with photography. But I never really wanted to. I wanted to render and draw and paint all my portraits. So I learned as much as I could, which actually is very valuable. It's valuable for me now as a photographer.
Right.
Because, I mean, and I do that. I tell any aspiring photographer to really absorb yourself with as much art. You know, go to a library, go to, if they even exist.
Yeah.
I mean, it's kind of sad. Libraries don't exist anymore. But, you know, and that's where I went. And then I took a career in graphic design and advertising. So I worked as an art director for many companies, even doing movie posters.
Okay.
We would hire photographers, so I got a whole look on the back end, kind of.
Right.
So when I made my transition, I already knew what to expect and what to provide and what to do, what angle to approach a job for clients. So, yeah.
Okay, cool. So I mean, that kind of gives you guys an idea, you know, a little bit about where he's coming from. Not necessarily the most common background for most photographers, which I think kind of, you know, gives him that edge or that, you know, variety in his photography that he kind of creates. So you kind of touched on, you know, that your dad was a photographer, that, you know, he came from, you know, like that painting background.
Right.
You had, you know, some experience, well, quite a lot of experience of working in the, you know, magazine, you know, that kind of area of the industry, right? So,
yeah, I mean, I worked actually... you know, when you talk about magazines, I did do a lot of the advertising campaigns for, you know, men's fitness, men's workout magazines, for Triathlete magazine. I did some jobs as a designer.
Right.
And then we would hire photographers, and I would see that they wouldn't implement my vision, what I saw.
Yeah.
So that's how I started. That's how I made my transition into photography.
Yeah.
I picked up a camera, set it on automatic for about 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
And I already knew what I wanted, so I shot everything in automatic. You know, I had my renders, my drawings, and yeah, I mean, shoot, there's nothing wrong with automatic. I'll get crucified for that, right?
Right.
Yeah. So, I mean, your vision is the most important thing, and I think that's for me personally, for my background and what I do for my work. Vision is what really comes across everything.
Sure. Yes, I mean, kind of training your eye, so to speak, you know, building yourself up, you know, towards the eventual career in photography. So with that in mind, I mean, where you're coming from with your experience, with your background.
Mm-hmm.
So how did that kind of play into, you know, what you specialize in now, in photography? You know, what are you best known for?
Well, now, I mean, I pretty much just do commercial portraiture here. I mean, I'm in the Valley. We're like, 4 miles from Universal City and, you know, 4 miles from Hollywood.
Right.
So, you know, depending where you live in, it kind of goes with the kind of work you're going to be able to do.
Mm-hmm.
Because, if you know, I mean, I lived an hour out of the city here before. I could never do what I do now.
Right.
You know, and photographers, really, like yourself, you have to think about, what do I want to pursue? You know, you probably, if you're working in a rural area, you're doing families.
Right.
You know, you're doing, I mean, I started doing senior portraiture. I started my career years ago.
Yeah.
It was all senior high school kids. Yeah. I mean, it was crazy. I mean, we would have to shoot sometimes 100 kids in a day.
Wow.
And that's just craziness. I mean, it's just like boot camp.
Right.
But you have to be like really supple to be able to move around, nimble to, hey, you know, you're interacting with the kid. You're creating an image, you're studying him, you're seeing, you know, you have to break the ice with the individual.
Right.
But then you have to create something artistic.
Yeah.
So that also helped me in my career now. But now it's just pretty much commercial portraiture. I work a lot with agencies. I work with specific talent scouts or publicists,
okay,
or the celebrity per se individually,
right?
You know, and I've had the honor for a little bit of my background, and I don't talk about this much, but yeah, I was making a list of, you know, you look back and you reflect on like, where am I now? What have I done? Because, you know, we're making plans on doing different things down, you know, from spring forward. And I see back in my career, I'm like, wait, I've photographed like 9 world champions.
Wow.
You know, I photographed Muhammad Ali, Evander Holyfield, Mike Tyson. I photographed the Boston Celtics, some of the athletes when they came to my home studio with the championship ball.
Wow.
NFL players. I've worked with the, you know, athletes from the NFL, from the NBA. I had a chance to photograph the Kings, the LA Kings,
right?
You know, at a yacht party. So, you know, and also the, you know, large iconic music figures, you know, female figures from like Helen Reddy. Well, even Helen Reddy, if I had to research, like, I mean, sad to say, but, you know, when I embark on a job, I have to get as much information as I can.
Sure. So
I started studying about her, and, you know, she's got a few Grammys, and she's got an iconic song now that's used for a women's lib, especially now with so much going on with, you know, the women's lib and women's rights.
Yeah.
Not to get involved with politics, but that's a national anthem song.
Right.
Which, and she also has the U.S. Postal Service stamp. So, you know, I've been blessed to come across and do a lot. Gypsy Kings, the Gypsy Kings were here playing. As a matter of fact, you see this drum here? The singer forgot his drum, which it's a footstool. I mean, don't let anybody hear that, but that's his drum. He forgot it when we did a photo shoot. But yeah, we've done a lot. So,
and I kind of touch on that. Today's actually International Women's Day, so I don't know that we're going to be posting that today. But you know, today as we're doing the shoot, today's International Women's Day. So power to all you women.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Shoot, I know. And you know, authoring too. I've authored books. I have a few. You know, I got 3 books in the works. And a couple that have been already printed. So, yeah, it's been a great journey. It's been a great journey. And I'm excited always to see what's happening next.
Right.
I mean, we'll be photographing, you know, another world champion in about 3 weeks with Tamron. And that'll be a nice journey as well, too.
So. Yeah. So stay tuned for that, guys. I mean, we're definitely going to be doing some big things, you know. Right? Yeah.
Right. We'll let you know. You know, I teach photographers from all ages, even professional photographers, and
yeah,
you know, they're always asking, well, what in your career, what can you tell me, what can help me, you know, to separate myself from the pack? Because, you know, the honest truth, it's a very competitive industry.
Yeah.
And you need something special really to kind of plug in into your work, and you see it. You know, we've been working together in a lot of things. And I studied 3 years of color in art school. And the fact of just knowledge of color adds such a dimension to your photography.
Yeah.
I'm dealing with skin tones, the psychology of color, how to even colorize your backgrounds,
right?
Filtering your lenses if you need to do that, putting special filters on your lenses. So that's something that really, you know, outside of the box of just camera and gear, you really have to kind of find that edge going further and further. Yeah, and it's always, you know, you always have to reinvent yourself. You always have to develop yourself as a photographer. You know, the late Bill Herter, you probably don't know who Bill Herter is, but he was the chief editor of Rangefinder.
Mm-hmm.
Good friend of mine. I used to judge for the WPPI as well because, I mean, Santa Monica was right up over the 4 or 5. On a good day, 12 minutes. On a bad day, two hours. But he gave me an interesting article of Where's the Cheese?
Where's the cheese?
Yeah, where's the cheese? What does that mean, right? Well, the cheese has been moved, meaning even in photography, like what was really the moneymaker, for instance, wedding photography was really big because, I mean, we got to admit it, before the real estate bust,
mm-hmm.
you know, I was doing food photography.
That's cool.
I mean, it was awesome. I was going to a restaurant. We would eat all day. I mean, we had to shoot maybe like 15 dishes, right? 15 mm-hmm. plates. We ate all day. We got paid, you know, $3,000 just to go shoot 12 plates.
Sign me up, right?
But you diversify the work you do. And when the real estate busted, people weren't investing anymore. Restaurants were either going under or they would pick up a camera and do this themselves.
Right.
So, you know, wedding photography was the same. I mean, think about it. You know, people were spending between $5,000, $10,000 and up on a wedding. So that money was not there anymore. So people were going on a smaller scale, either somebody they knew who knew photography or a less expensive photographer. So Bill Herter said, hey, the cheese has been moved. So it's up to us to go look, you know, where can we make the money? Like, how can we diversify our business? I mean, and you see, I do a lot. I mean, if I'm not authoring, I'm teaching conferences. I'm either nationally, I'm doing stuff, workshops that we do here in the studio. I teach at some of the big platforms like, you know, the Photo Plus in New York or WPPI. Or I might be in Colombia or somewhere in South America or Mexico teaching. So, you know, you gotta really broaden what you do. But at the end of the day, you have to have a specialty. You know, I tell, don't be lost in doing everything because then you become nothing. You get lost. But you also have to expand, you know, what you're able to do creatively. So, I mean, that's something that, you know, you could learn from that.
Yeah, of course. And that's something that, you know, hopefully a lot of you guys learn from as well. You know, going on that same line of conversation there, what would you say you're best known for? Like, as far as
My
what
hair,
you
man. Actually,
Right.
my hair. I need a haircut, right?
No, it looks good, man. I wish a little bit jealous here on my side of the screen here. But I mean, as far as like what you're known for, like people that, let's say they go on to hernanphotography.com, you know, let's say clients that are prospecting photographers, what's something that makes you stand out as a photographer? And like you were talking about just right now, as far as having that edge, you know, what is something you say that you're known for and you specialize in?
I think, you know, I think at the end of the day, when all the dust settles and you look at your body of work, and I've done this before because I've done articles for Scott Calvey for Photoshop User, and, you know, I've done some authoring, and well, that's one of the questions they ask, like, Hernan, you know, what do you perceive your style to be, or what identifies you? And even the editors will tell me, you know, what really strikes me about your work is the expression. You know, every image speaks. Even from a child, I mean, you see a picture we saw, a kid just laughing big, who's like not even a year old, to, you know, Helen Reddy. You know, she's done everything. She's sitting on a chair, and it's an expression of who she is. So it really comes down to identifying the person, the individual. I mean, really, it just take lights aside and cameras and everything. Lights, action, camera. When you dim the lights and you look at that image, it has to be the person recorded on that image, on that portrait. So I think that would be what identifies me.
So that's the edge that you bring. That's what people hire you for, is the expression, the life that you capture, that you create too,
All
through
right.
the relationships that you build, just as the type of personality, and that really comes through on the photos when you deal with clients. So.
Well, absolutely. And you know, when you're working with celebrities too, and they also identify themselves as somebody because they know who their true identity is. But then at the same time, they also have this identity that's perceived by you and me, by the general public. So it's almost like a double-edged sword because, you know, I need to identify. When I see them, I study them so much that I feel like I know them because I'm looking at pictures and videos and everything. But then again, I have them here present in front of me, and they're completely different. I mean, they're relaxed, you know, or they're just really a humorous person, and the general public won't see that. That's why my portraits are even different than celebrities, because you've seen some of my work. They're, oh wow, this is so and so. Like they're not even recognizable as far as their expressions go, because I capture them of, you know, for their true identity. So that's really important in any style of portraiture you do.
And I feel like that's kind of lost. I don't know if it's necessarily my generation of photographers or just photography in general, that I feel like a lot of people miss that. You know, you go and look through some people's galleries, or you have, you know, people that are just starting out in the photography community, and they're trying to look up to somebody to model themselves after. So that's a really important thing I think is missed, is, you know, in the eyes and the expression on the face, the life, you know, of the
Absolutely.
person.
That's a good point you make, because, and this is why it's great that we interact, because you're, you know, how many generations behind me are you? But the fact is that your generation has gone, you know, and, you know, kids behind you are growing up in a whole different place that I grew up as a photographer. I mean, figure this. I'm talking to you about looking at portraits and renderings of masters. I did that class that we taught, and we did a class recently, and I was teaching about identifying your style, mm-hmm. and I brought images from 1834, right. which is crazy, right?
Yeah.
Those images are so relevant today, but if you think about generations from past, you know, to my generation, like that's all we did. We study faces and expressions, but we also had the time to absorb all this. You know, right. we had the time to research and look at magazines and, you know, go to libraries. And now it's different. Now it's like immediate. Social yeah. media and the pace that this society has and, you know, this generation has is, that's why it's easy, it, you know, you easily get lost right. with finding that expression. So it's a good point you make, because it's a key factor, but it's a factor that's really lost.
Right.
Right?
And you see it. I mean, you see it all over. Whether it's Instagram, Facebook, you name it. I mean, it's either you hit it right on the target, or you missed it. But I guess going from there too is, so now I've kind of done some, you know, I did some research on you when, you know, he was teaching actually at a class, at a workshop that I was attending. And that's kind of how me and Hernan here met. Now tell me a little bit as far as like, you know, some of the accolades that you've received, some of the awards that you had, and how that kind of led to some of the exposure with some of the sponsors that you now have attained for yourself that you represent.
Yeah, you know, I look back too, and I was looking back at the sponsors I have. It's nice. I mean, it's gratifying to me, and it's not always a one-way thing, because a lot of photographers get lost. Hey, what can I get for myself? What can I
right.
do?
Yeah.
And, you know, I try to really separate myself from going, because relationships. And I look back at my sponsors, and I've had them for, gosh, over 10 years. And it all started with the class I taught at WPPI. You know, at least over 10 years ago, I did a class in WPPI, and it was a Spanish platform class, because okay. I'm bilingual, guys. My name is Hernan. Yeah. right? So I started, and the first thing they tell me is like, could you give me a list of sponsors? Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh. Like I was wet behind the ears. Like what the heck right. are sponsors? Like what are you talking about? Like I don't right. even have anybody.
Right.
Like I bought all my gear and all my equipment, right?
That's me.
So right, that's what we are. That's what we all are or were, right?
Right.
So they said, hey, give me a list of sponsors. And I'm like, okay, well, what do I need to do? And I said, right. I even told Bill, that was Bill Herter. I said, help me out. Like what? He's like, Hernan, well, you know, they support you and you really affiliate yourself with somebody, some equipment you use and such. So I started going through a list of all my equipment, and I was using mm-hmm. my Tamron lenses, and I was using like the Westcott gear. Mm-hmm. I had, you know, like a Dynalite pack, a power pack. Mm-hmm. So it really was everything I was using.
Sure.
But it kind of opened my eyes to like, oh, wow, like maybe I could contact these people right. and say, hey, this is what I create. This is what I used to create all my work.
Right.
And I created all this body of work, and mm-hmm. and I say, hey, you know, could you support me? Could you help me out, right? Throw me a bone or something. But that's how it started. But, you know, it really comes to preparation and opportunity. It's an intersection of preparation and opportunity. And this is another advice I would give to you and your generation.
Right.
You know, you really, and this is, I'm helping Daniel out here, you know. I mean, it's a mutual thing we have. I'm like, hey, come and learn as much as you can.
Right.
You know, I'm like, I'm an open book.
Sure.
And I'm very selective. You know me. It's like, you know, we have opportunities to get a lot of help, but I'm selective, you know, who I want around me and to build my team.
Sure.
But, you know, I really like you, and we kind of see the same thing eye to eye. So I'm like, this is a good guy. I want to help you in your career.
Right.
So this is what you start doing. You start building yourself to be as prepared as you can.
Okay.
I say, do your homework in the studio. Mm-hmm. Like, I would rather you go and test and fail a whole photo shoot with your sister or your cousin.
Right.
What's she going to do, right? Like,
yeah.
She's known you all her life. She's going to slap you across the face. Like,
there we go.
Like, damn, you know, you're not going to. Anyway, but you're better doing that
right.
and learning from that than going in ill-prepared and getting a good job, a good opportunity, and blowing it because. Yeah. You know, word gets out, and especially like in this industry, like for the work I do, it's all referral. So if I screw up in one job or with one publicist or one agent, yeah, as big as Hollywood is, it's such a, it's a small, the further up you go, it bottlenecks.
Yeah.
All the big people, and they all come here in one committee, and they're all talking about each other. So
right.
I make sure I'm super prepared. And then I do this. So I started doing all my work and I built my website and I started doing print compositions. I started submitting stuff and I got a lot of great stuff. I mean, it's gratifying when you do this work and you create a beautiful image and you put it up for competition. I haven't joined a competition in a moment, but you know, I did join like the Black and White Spider War, which I got out of like thousands and thousands, tens of thousands of images. I got a third place in fashion. So I started researching all the photographers who did that competition with me. And these guys, some of the guys were shooting like covers of Vogue magazine. So I'm like, oh, I'm in good company.
Right.
So I think I'm doing something right.
Right.
So it just gives you a little bit of satisfaction to that. But I started building all my body of work and, right. and putting my resume together and all the stuff I would do. All the highlights, and I put it out. You know, I put it out, and I send it out to Westcott and Tamron, and now we have a long-lasting relationship.
Sure.
You know, these people now, not only is it a business relationship, but they're friends.
Right.
You know, yeah. I could sit down and have a beer with them in Vegas, and, you know, we're, you know, business is business and friendship, but it's, at the end of the day, you do business with people you like, and that's what it comes down to. So, you know, it's a blessing to have, you know, have these people around you as your team. You
sure.
know? And, you know, after so many years, too, I mean, I'm always pushing and pushing and pushing right. to keep on. You know, you're never complacent, at least for myself. I never want to be in a place of complacency.
Sure.
I always want to be pushing myself as a professional. And I became, I'm a Tamron Image Master.
Okay.
I'm a Westcott Elite Pro, which, I mean, they're great honors. I'm a Dynalite VIP. I'm a Moab Image Master, too.
Right.
I'm a data color visionary. So, you know, it's a great curriculum. So I could go at the end of my career. And now I want to educate. I want to educate you. I want to help. I want to really, you know, there's a big void, I think, with young photographers because, you know, everything's so automated and you put this camera and it does great stuff for you. Then, like, how do you light and what side of the face you light and such? So,
and you know, color also. I mean, like you, Roscoe, right?
So. Yeah, yeah. Roscoe's a big, you know, in the past maybe 5 years, I've been working with Roscoe, with Joe Svensson at Roscoe.
Mm-hmm.
And it's great because when I got involved with him, though I knew color and I studied color, he's a technician.
Right.
You know, I mean, they're developing filters for your lights. So even when you're going out and creating this beautiful, like we did a beauty campaign for a celebrity, you know, and we lit everything with a certain filter.
Right.
Because everything looks beautiful and the skin tones right. look like they glow and it's straight out of the camera. So ever since then, you know, my knowledge of creating with certain colors
mm-hmm.
and palettes also has diversified my work. So, I mean, that's great.
So what are some of the other sponsors that are backing you or that you've attained?
Well, we got Tamron, we got Westcott, we got Dynalite. Wacom tablets, which I mean, they're great. You know, it's I can't say enough of my sponsors because every sponsor, every picture I take, every portrait I take, and even in the field, I think about, gosh, if it wasn't for this piece of equipment, I probably would not be able to create this.
Yeah,
you know, that's the honest truth. I could create so much magic with one light.
Yeah,
but the fact is, if I have all these things at my disposal, it's so. I feel like my sponsors are part of my journey. Everything that I think about them, and they appreciate that too.
Sure.
I got Siconic. Of course, if you don't meter your light, you don't know what's happening.
Yeah.
Pocket Wizard, Roscoe, Data Color, Spider Checker. Oh my gosh, that's that gray card.
Yeah.
Like you see, I never leave home without it.
Yeah, it's with you everywhere, right?
We turn the car around. We forgot the gray car. Let's turn the car around. So really, I mean, all these things, and I use them.
Right.
It isn't like, okay, you know, let me get all these sponsors and let me use this and let me get more and more and more.
Sure.
Because what does it mean if I don't use it? All this is valuable to me. Like Nissan flashes. I connected with Bruce Michelson about 3 years ago at the Photo Plus show. I had to teach a photo walk. And I need a portable light. So I connected with Nissan flashes.
Yeah.
And, you know, to this day, I mean, we use it all the time. You see it.
Yeah.
Even if I have to go shoot sometimes a celebrity shoot or something that really does not allow my Bajas, you know, from Dynalite or my big gear.
Sure.
I got to take two little portable flashes on a backpack. Well, I mean, it's perfect. I know light enough to modify that light, put a right. filter, soften it, undo, put a little umbrella, whatever I need to do. So all this stuff I use. So, I mean, it's great to have the support from the sponsors.
Right. So, I mean, I guess a better question to start out actually would have been, who aren't you sponsored by?
Frodo, for instance. For Manfrotto, I have the tripod, which, I mean, I shoot loose. I love being, like, mobile and everything. But really, sometimes you have to create just these perfectly framed shots throughout a whole series. You know, and you could do this for catalog work. You're doing something or web, you know, you're doing something for a client that's all web-based. So right. everything has to be precise, and you cannot have that, you know, inconsistency of where that framing is. So Manfrotto, not only that, I'm older too, man. I've had a couple of motorcycle wrecks. So right. my back goes off. You're shooting 10 hours and my back is killing me. So not, for that reason alone too,
yeah.
you know, you got a 7200 millimeter lens, which is kind of heavy. So, you know, and the camera bag, it's great. I mean, I use all this stuff, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I think the big part of it is too, guys, you know, that gear is not cheap. And it's not cheap for a reason. You want to make sure that you're getting quality products or quality gear so that when you're using those things for a job, like I've seen Hernan do, he needs his gear to work, plain and simple. So, I mean, these sponsorships, these relationships that he has, it's not for, you know, any other reason than he believes in the products, he believes in the gear, and he can depend on them when it comes to a job.
Right, absolutely. And you know what? I mean, they appreciate that too. And looking at it from their perspective, we're top pros working. Like for, you know, for Westcott Elite Pros. I mean, you got Jerry Giannis, who's the top wedding photographer. So we have, you know, the top photographers. We're testing this gear for you guys because it also helps the company. There's sure. an awareness of, hey, listen, you know, this is all great. The light's beautiful, but, you know, maybe modify this or maybe add this or make it user-friendly. As simple as making it user-friendly. I mean, you know, we know the stuff, but let's say you get a 50-year-old woman in Ohio. I mean, Westcott's from Ohio, so. but you get somebody who, like, it's just not easy for, if it's not easy for me to use, then it's not going to be easy for an elderly woman to use. So these are the things that really, we didn't think about that. Or, you know, just modifying stuff, testing all my lenses. I'm always testing and, you know, and it's, the lenses are amazing now. Tamron's glass now really is up there, honestly, with Canon and Nikon.
Sure.
I mean, even the reviews on some of the prime lenses.
Yeah.
I know the 17, the 30, I mean, the wide angle lens was, Tamron excelled in lens flare,
yeah.
you know, and even the moisture. So there's a lot of things that it does, vignetting, I mean, they and because we help, we know, like we come up with things that, you know, maybe we could work with this, you know, so even Alien Skin, when I work with Alien Skin, and it's a software, I mean, it's the only software, post-processing software I use for my images.
Yeah.
Which, you know, which, I mean, I have the support of Alien Skin, which is great. We're doing beta testing sometimes. They send us the next software, you know. If it's 10, then they're sending 11.
Yeah, and then that's an important part of his process. I mean, that goes into the end result of what he's providing these celebrity clients. And that goes into it, the post-processing. So that's not something too little, you know, to kind of glass over. So
No. Well, for instance, we just photographed Mary Carmen Lopez. Now, she's a really strong and upcoming celebrity, land celebrity, which there's a few. I mean, sad to say, but, you know, but she's young and, you know, she's great to work with. Yeah. She's got a big, she's with a big agency, 3 Arts Entertainment in Hollywood. And she just did a series for Oprah, or the Oprah Channel, with a big director. So we created this amazing body of images for her.
Sure.
From fashion to, you know, Girl Next Door and everything. But again, I'm talking about the post-processing, and I want to get back to Alien Skin. I don't like, because I'm a purist in regards to, like, I used to shoot film and I know what it looked like.
Yeah.
So I don't want my work to have a shelf life where, oh, I remember that from the 80s or from the 90s or from the 2000s. And we keep on pushing.
Yeah.
But, you know, again, I go back to those images of the 1800s. That image of, you know, those images I showed you guys in class is the same today, 2017, which is amazing.
Right.
Had that been done through a processing software, like if we do that now, oh my gosh, yeah. you know, that dates you to a certain time. So yeah. Alien Skin allows you to give you just the texture and the feel of grain and grid, if you want some of like the Kodak Portra, which I love. You know, sometimes it takes a little bit of the saturation off a little bit. It adds a little bit of that grain, but
Yeah.
not where it's noisy, you know, or grainy,
Right.
but just the right texture. So I mean, that's the only aftermarket software I use for my images.
Editing, right. Yeah, well, I mean, and that kind of goes back full circle, you know, going back to, you know, kind of where you started and, you know, where you're at now, you know, celebrity photographer, you know, all these sponsors, these relationships that you've built, you know, over these, you know, these years of your experience. And I hope you guys kind of got a better idea of who Hernan is, you know, with Hernan photography, what he represents, where he's coming from.
We got a lot of good things happening and coming, so.
Stay tuned. We're going to be doing some videos on the gear. We're going to be coming out some stuff. And we're also going to be having some workshops coming up as well. So definitely stay tuned and keep your eye on this guy. He's going.